Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create a surrealistic landscape of a giant glass ball hovering many feet over the landscape's ground. For your convenience, I provided this image so you can follow along. Its link is in my video's description or project files. If you'd prefer to use your own photo instead, go to Image and Image Size, and make its width and height approximately this much, and its resolution 150 pixels per inch. This will ensure that the filter amounts we'll be using will have similar results on your image as mine. Let's find the exact center of our document by going to View. Make sure rulers and snap are checked. If they aren't, just click them to make them active. Go to the top ruler and drag down a guideline to the center. It'll snap in place because we have snap checked. If you don't see the guideline, press Ctrl or Command H. Go to the ruler on the left and again drag the guideline to the center. We'll create the orb by first cutting a square from the center of the landscape. Open your rectangular marquee tool and go to the center of the guidelines. Click and hold as you press Alt or Option plus Shift and drag out a square selection to the edges. Press Ctrl or Command J to cut and copy the square to its own layer. Click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Duplicate Layer. This will create a separate document of the square image. Open the Destination Document list and click New. Let's name it Square. We'll trim the document to the image. Go to Image and Trim. Tick Transparent Pixels and make sure all the boxes under Trim Away are checked. Go to Filter, Distort, and Spherize. Make the amount 100%. Repeat the last filter by pressing Alt-Control-F on Windows or Option-Command-F on a Mac. Or go to Filter and Spherize. If you'd like to spherize it a bit more, open back Spherize and reduce the amount. We'll cut the orb out by opening your elliptical marquee tool and going to a corner. Press and hold Shift as you drag the tool to the opposite corner. Pressing Shift ensures that the selection is a perfect circle. To ensure that the selection is inside the perimeter of the orb, go to Select, Modify, and Contract. Contract it 2 pixels. Then cut and copy it to its own layer. To place the orb onto our landscape, press V on your keyboard to open your Move tool and drag it onto the tab of the landscape. Without releasing your mouse or pen, press and hold Shift as you drag it down and release. Pressing Shift kept the orb centered over the landscape. To resize the orb, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in approximately this much. If your version of Photoshop is CC 2019 or later, press and hold Alt or Option as you drag it in. Then press Enter or Return. To raise or lower it, press and hold the Shift key as you press the up or down arrow on your keyboard. Pressing Shift jumps the orb 10 pixels at a time instead of just 1 pixel. Hide the guidelines by pressing Ctrl or Command H. We can also trash the square. Make it active and press the Delete key on your keyboard or drag it to the trash icon. Check your foreground and background colors. If they're not black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Double-click the orb to open its layer style window. Click Inner Glow. If the box isn't white, click it and when the color picker opens, pick white. The blend mode is overlay, and the opacity is 100%. The source is edge, the choke is 0%, and the size is 70 pixels. Let's collapse the glow effect to save a little space in the Layers panel. Control-click or Command-click the orb to make a selection of its circular shape. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection. Notice as soon as you made the layer mask, our foreground and background colors inverted. This is normal. However, since we'll be brushing black into our layer mask, we need to make our foreground color black. Click this icon to invert the colors, or press X on your keyboard. Open your brush tool and brush picker. Pick a soft, round brush. We'll adjust the size in a moment. Make the hardness 0% and the opacity and flow 100%. Then press Enter or Return. To adjust the size of your brush, make sure your caps lock key is off and press the left or right bracket key on your keyboard. The size of my brush is 700 pixels. Make sure the layer mask is active and place your cursor approximately here on the orb. Click once. Click the adjustment layer icon and click black and white. Adjustment layers affect all the layers below them in the Layers panel. If we want to affect just the one layer beneath it, click the clipping mask icon or press Alt-Control-G on Windows or Option-Command-G on a Mac. You can also go to Layer and create clipping mask. Open the preset list and click Maximum Black. Make the opacity 30%. Click the adjustment layer icon again, and this time click Curves. Then clip it to the orb. If you don't see the entire Curves panel, drag the window down. The Curves panel represents the image's tonal range. The upper right area of the graph is the highlights, the lower left area is the shadows, and the middle area is the midtones. Go to the middle point and drag the diagonal line down and to the right approximately this much. Place your brush over the sky, reduce its size, and brush tightly over the area to mask out that area, thereby brightening it. I'll make more room in the Layers panel by dragging the Curves panel back up. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Name it Highlight and change its Blend Mode to Overlay. Control-click or Command-click the orb to make a selection of its shape and click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection. Make the layer active again. Invert your foreground and background colors so white is your foreground color. With your brush tool still active, make its size 500 pixels and click once approximately here. Make a new layer and name it Shadow Reflection. Change its blend mode to soft light and decrease its opacity to 80%. Make a new layer and name it Highlight. Change its blend mode to overlay and reduce its opacity to 80% as well. Control-click or Command-click the layer mask to make a selection of it. Go to Select and Transform Selection. At the top, make sure the chain link icon is active, and in either the width or the height field, type in 87%. Then press Enter or Return. Hide the selection by pressing Ctrl or Command H twice. With your brush's size at 500 pixels, click once approximately here. Make the shadow reflection active and invert your colors. Gently brush over the lower right and bottom of the orb. Make the top layer active and make a new layer above it. Control-click or Command-click the layer mask to make a selection of its shape and fill the selection with any color. I'll fill it with my background color. Then deselect it. Decrease the fill to 0%. Doing this makes the layer invisible, but it'll retain the full visibility of any layer styles that we add to it. Double-click the layer to open its layer style window. Click Inner Glow and make sure the box is white. The blend mode is overlay, the opacity is 60%, and the size is 80 pixels. Scroll to the bottom of the Layers panel and make a selection of the orb. Click the background to make it active and make a new layer above it. Name it Shadow. Go to Select and Transform Selection. Click off the Chain Link button. This unlinks the width and the height of the transform. For the height, type in 8%. Go inside the transform's bounding box and press and hold the Shift key as you drag the selection down below the orb. Holding Shift kept it vertical as you dragged it down. Then press Enter or Return. Go to Select, Modify, and Feather. Feather it 20 pixels and fill it with black. Then deselect it. Reduce its opacity to 60%. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.